Last year, I was in the audience for This Is My Brain. As I heard the poems and stories, saw the art and drama, I cried and I knew that someday I would come up and share my story. So when I saw the audition call for this year, I knew that this was my time. It's important to let others know what we've been through and that it's not our fault, and we can and we will get better. And so I want to start here from where I am. I want to tell you that it's better. I'm getting better and I can breathe now. It's possible to breathe again. However, in order to be here, I have to start at the scary part, at the beginning. As far as I can remember, I was always my father's special girl. He liked to take me places, hold my hand, kiss me, lay down with me at night, and touch me. When I was in the third or fourth grade, I stayed overnight with my friend. And her dad came and he tucked us in. And he gave us a kiss on the forehead, and he left. And I said to her, I said, when does he come back? She didn't know what I was talking about. And so that's when I learned that not all daddies slept with or had sex with their kids. And I was confused and scared, and that's when my spiraling started. And my experiences continued through my teen years. Quite often he would be home when I got home from school. He would be down in the hallway, he would hide, he would jump out at me. He came at me more and more, and I wasn't safe in my own home, and not anywhere. And I was especially not safe in my own bedroom. I moved furniture against the door. I slept under the bed. I tried not to be home. I felt like I was spinning. It was a giant spiral out of control, going and going, and nothing could stop it. When I was in high school, I tried to kill myself by cutting my wrist. I didn't cut deep enough, and it hurt. So I cleaned myself up and put a bandage on and went to school. The nurse saw me in the hallway. I had blood dripping down my arm and into my sleeve. And they contacted the administration. They called my mother. The social worker came in. Yeah. But it was supposed to be better. It didn't. I ended up staying in the children's home, then a couple of foster homes, and finally at a halfway house for wayward teens. Now, I was bounced around for about 2 years, and then I was sent right back home. And all of that and nothing, the only thing that really happened is I lost a chunk of time that should have been great years with my friends. I covered my pain up with drugs and alcohol, and the spiraling continued. When I was 18, my greatest wish came true. My father died. No, I didn't kill him. Although there have been many times that I wish I had, and I had the strength and the power to do so. He died of a heart attack. Just like that, he was gone. Life should have been better, but it got worse. I went to the cemetery. I saw him there, next to the grave, wearing the hat and coat he always wore. He died, and yet he was still there. And I began to lose sleep. And I began to lose chunks of time in my life. I would find myself in places that I didn't know how I got there, or when I got there, or how long I'd been there. Even when I was home, I would see people that weren't there, looking at me from outside my windows. I even saw a man down the road by the mailbox. My own personal Michael Myers. In case you don't know him, that's the guy, the creepy guy in the Halloween movies. My nightmares had become daymares. I began sleeping during the day and in places where I could have my back up against the wall. Sometimes that meant sleeping in the back of closets, in doorways, and under the stairs. My life seemed to be spiraling again. So we fast forward a couple more years. I went into drug treatment and I got clean. I struggled with my life and went into therapy where I got a diagnosis. Post-traumatic stress disorder and dissociative disorder. Things began to calm and make sense. And I learned through breathing treatments, I learned self-hypnosis so I could sleep better. I still have these things. They didn't go away, but the symptoms are greatly reduced and I can really breathe again. And now I just spiral where it's fun, like on a tilt wheel.